categorically that national health insurance would be funded from tax. At the moment, the public sector, the 250 billion or thereabouts that is spent in the public sector is funded from tax. It comes out of the general revenue fund of the state. It is our money that we spend through VAT, personal taxes, company taxes, excise duties, and whatever other form of, you know, sin taxes, etc., all go into the fiscus, and that is what pays for the 4.5% of GDP that is currently spent in the public sector. Now, in order to cover everybody for everything, we need to have, instead of a voluntary contribution for a few people for healthcare that may well be more beyond what they need or over-serviced, or the challenges we have in the private sector are well documented, we need to have that, some of that money in the public purse. Now, how that happens is a matter between, it's a treasury matter, and it can be done through increasing VAT, which many countries have done. It can be done through increasing personal taxes. It can be done through earmarking excise duties, etc. But it can also be done by designated payroll tax. Now, at the moment, we don't have a designated payroll tax. The bill moots that and suggests that should be an option. That is not a health decision. That will be a treasury decision when the time comes. And remember that for those of us who have medical aids, we will no longer need the medical aid. So whatever I'm currently spending voluntarily on medical aid, if the equivalent or less than that is being paid on tax, whether it's a payroll tax or whether it's an increase in personal tax, is going into the general pool, and I know I will not be vulnerable when I get sick, then for me personally, I see that as an advantage, not a disadvantage. But we mustn't try and pretend it's not going to be taxed. It will be taxed. That's how we collect collective money in this country and in most countries.